streaming 24/7.
African Crest Radio.
Yellow bullet. But you know, we look at models such as Ella Gwek, who are making money and being an ambassador for Human Aid also. I think she, you know, she's doing quite well. She's doing very well. So in the studio I have Miss Congo SA to tell us more about this, because when I saw the posters that were around campus, I'm like, Miss Congo SA, okay, is this for the Miss Congo that's going to happen in Congo? Exactly what's going on? But welcome, Ellie. How are you?
Thank you very much. I'm good, thank you.
Great. Please do introduce yourself.
Well, my name is Edith Kachibombo, the first and former Miss Congo SA 2012.
Some are former.
The first and former.
Former?
Yeah.
I'm like, already former? It's done. Like, it's over like that. But tell us more about the initiative of Miss Congo SA. Why do such an activity, an event rather, and why have Miss Congo SA?
Well, I know when a lot of South Africans hear about Miss Congo, they're like, wow, happening here in South Africa, really? But then basically, it's to change that mindset. When people hear Congolese, they hear people that cannot achieve. They have a certain mindset about the country itself. And even with the Congolese community themselves, they think that we are unable to do certain things in foreign countries. And our plan is just to change that mindset and tell them, you know what, if you set yourself to do something, then you can. Like, I was the first Miss Congo. A lot of people thought that I would be quiet, I would not be doing anything this year. But fortunately, I've got a good team. The board of Miss Congo has been helping me a lot. And I must say, it's been a wonderful opportunity and experience. Yeah. I've been able to talk to a lot of young girls living here in South Africa, Congolese young girls, that were at the end of life, if I should say. They felt like they could not do anything further. They felt like, because I'm in South Africa, I'm a nobody.
Yeah.
But through me, they were able to see that, no, I have a future. I'm able to do something as long as I'm just proud of who I am and as long as I'm grateful for the opportunities that have been given to me.
And finding confidence also plays a part in that, which is something that you had. Because I asked you the first question, I was like, whoa, yo. You know, you're very, very confident, which is great, I guess, for someone in your position and being an ambassador for Miss Congo SA. So how far do you guys go in terms of reaching out to, you know, especially young ladies?
Well, we go as far as going to schools, high schools, and speaking to the Congolese girls there, just to make sure that they're aware of what's actually happening. We go to varsities, we do guest appearances, we go to certain events. So wherever we can go, we go.
Yeah.
Just to make sure they know.
Yeah. Okay, so you had the first Miss Congo SA last year.
Yeah.
And of course you were the winner.
Yes.
What events and activities have you done, you know, within your reign?
Well, I've done a lot of fashion shows. I've done a lot of fashion shows. And obviously it was my first time. I was not a model before, if I should say. It was just something that I did not even plan on doing. A friend brought me to the auditions. So I was given the opportunity to do fashion shows, and I was doing very well because I had a good team and they were encouraging me. I've done a bit of public speaking also. So that's basically it. And a few events. I've been working with the charity Mother Teresa in Yeovil,
A
charity of my choice. And I must say I've been enjoying it. I've been getting a lot of help. I've been speaking to people about donating clothes and food. And the response, I must say, has been very good. So I'm grateful for that.
Oh, wow. All right. So now she says current and former. Like, yeah. There's a point behind that. Now, it's been a year.
Yeah.
And you're now looking for the next ambassador.
Yeah.
Okay. So where have you guys been? And now I know you're at TT, but where else have you guys gone?
We've been at VUT. We've been at UJ. And last week we were in Rosettenville. And the response and the girls that have been coming, I must say the quality has been very good.
Wow.
So, yeah, we're really looking forward to this year's Miss Congo.
And somehow, TUT, yeah. How was TUT today? Did it work out? It was a Friday. You should have had it more on a Thursday.
Well, we usually have our auditions on a Saturday. This is the first time we have it on a Friday. And we don't have as much girls as we expected, but the girls that came for me have been wonderful.
Yeah.
I'm very happy that we were able to meet them. Personality-wise, they were really good. And yeah, it's been great.
Yeah, shout out to all those girls. So they're going to be having an event. And when is the Miss Congo SA
happening? The final event is on the 14th of December at Melrose Arc at Shares Inn. it is a hotel and there's a club right there, so the after party is going to move straight to the club, and it would be great if we have more South African people coming.
Let's come support, man. I always say it doesn't matter what corner you come from, as long as you're in Africa, you're my sister, you're my brother, and it's done like that. All right, so what now, if let's say, you know, I'm a Congolese and I actually want to enter the competition, what's the procedure?
Well, you have to be from 18 to 24 years old.
Okay.
You need to have a Congolese bloodline. You don't have to be born in Congo. You can be born in South Africa, but as long as you have Congolese bloodline somewhere, then you can come. And obviously, you need to have confidence.
Mm.
You do not want to go in front of girls and you see this girl who knows she's going to win it, and you come there and you have no self-esteem or confidence. And also, just have that confidence and know that, you know what, I'm it. So that's exactly what we need. And if you have that, then you can come.
All right, so you guys are looking for how many people in the end? 12, is it?
At the end, well, we have a knockout stage.
Uh-huh.
So right now, if there's a lot of girls that we want, then they make it through.
Oh.
But then at the knockout stage, that's when we narrow it down to maybe 12 or maybe 14. But it depends on the amount of girls that we get.
That would be depending on how many girls you guys have now, in terms of how many people you'd have at the final event participating.
Mm-hmm.
All right, why just Miss Congo, not Miss that? Because I know a lot of guys. I know a lot of African people. Like, I do. Why not Miss that?
Well, as you know, this is just the second edition of Miss Congo.
Yeah.
And obviously, we're going to start with a woman first, because there's more women than these guys.
Mm-hmm.
And as a Congolese community, when it comes to the mindset, more people think that, you know what, if you're going to take part in a modeling competition, then you are a prostitute, you know.
Yeah.
As looking back at our cultures and the way women are treated, as in, you know, in Congo, women don't really have value.
Yes.
And if you just try and bring yourself out there, then they think that, no, this girl is too much.
Too so you want to,
she's too forward, and she wants to know more. So we just want to change that mindset and tell the Congolese girls that, you know what, no, you can do something.
Yeah.
You have the opportunity, why don't you just take it?
Ah, the environment also allows, if I want to add that. But yeah, if people, like, can anybody enter, as long as you're between 18 and 24, that you don't have to be in tertiary or...
Anybody can enter.
All
but then at the end, you also need to be available.
Okay.
Because you could be doing matric, for example, and I think that's not gonna allow you to balance the two. So as a person that's gonna enter, you need to know that, fine, I'm gonna be available at this time and that time. So it's up to you as a person. You'll know if you can enter.
All right. This is all to the ladies. As long as you have some sort of bloodline in it, Bona, you qualify, and you can come through to the next edition. Where are you having your next edition?
So? In Yeovil.
In Yeovil.
And
the address?
Well, the address will still be noted, but you can check the Facebook page. It's called the Miss Congo Essay Pageant, and we have a Twitter account. So just go on the Facebook page and you're going to get all the information.
Hey, man, everybody's got Facebook
nowadays.
So it's the
Miss Congo Essay Pageant.
The Miss Congo Essay Pageant. Then you'll find out more information, also numbers, who can you contact if you guys want to be out there. And I think I'm going to attend the event. It's happening on the
14th of December.
And that is in Yeovil, right?
In Melrose.
Melrose. Woo, Bona. Classic places, I told you, Nia. So that is what is happening. So if you're confused, like, Miss Congo Essay, what is that about? I think it's clear, even I understand it myself. Thank you so much, my lady, coming through. I hope you find another beauty. Hey, man, I love black beauty. It's like, beauty is not always about being a yellow bone. We have a lot of beautiful African sisters, man. So yeah, big ups to all the black sisters out there. And thank you so much for spending a couple of minutes clarifying what's going on. And later, let us know more about this. And thank you guys also. There's a photographer. He's making me shine. Thank you too for the pictures. All right, the professor coming through with Ama Volontia, as requested on Facebook. So that is closed in terms of the listeners' playlist. On the flip side of 4 o'clock, what are we talking about today?